killings were extremely wicked, shockingly evil, vile.
Did you do these things, Ted?
This is all gonna end.
It's only gonna end with the truth.
So a lot of reviewers out there on the internet I've seen have called extremely wicked, shockingly evil, and vile. Mediocre, some of them called it subpar, some of them said it didn't live up to expectations. I'm about ready to tell you why they're wrong. Hey, what's up, guys? Now, I've never actually done a review of a movie, TV show, anything like that, but I wanted to come to you guys for the simple fact that I feel like a lot of people are kind of missing the point of the movie about Ted Bundy called Extremely Wicked, Shockingly Evil, and Vile. I've heard a lot of people say different negative things. I've heard some positive things, but I've also heard a lot of people that I feel like maybe they didn't necessarily understand the viewpoint that the filmmakers were trying to make with it. And I feel like personally, just let's start with the casting, and then we'll work from there. I think personally with Zac Efron, they chose somebody that honestly they couldn't have done a better choice. I was a little bit kind of confused when they said they were going to pick him because you really only saw him in Disney movies and then stuff like Bad Grandpa and Neighbors and things like that. So it was kind of a toss-up. I think they ended up doing a really, really good job because he was able to personify a lot of what Ted Bundy was. Now, I know that we look at pictures of Ted Bundy from back in the day and we say he wasn't that good looking of a guy or whatever. And I think in that sense, Zac Efron was kind of a good choice for modern audiences because modern audiences don't necessarily look as much at charisma and the ability to speak and the ability to draw people into your words like it used to be. You know, we live in a very materialistic world now as we used to not. And I think that was a lot of what people felt so attracted to back then was his charisma and his ability to talk himself in or out of any situation. In today's society, I think that needed to be more visualized, which is why they picked somebody as visually attractive as Zac Efron, is because that's what instantly drew people in. Notice like Netflix had to put out that disclaimer that you needed to focus on the bad things he had done and not necessarily start like really enjoying him for how he looked and things. And I think that that was actually a really, really good example is because the original Ted Bundy, the real Ted Bundy had this way that he could talk people into situations such as these women that he would deal with where he would draw them in and he would trick them and get them to trust him and stuff like that. And not just in the short term where he did with the murders, but also in how he did with Liz. And that was also explained a little bit in the movie where he was able to get her to overlook a lot of these red flags. And if you read in beyond what the movie shows, you can see that there was a lot of issues with Liz, a lot of red flags that popped up, and in a lot of ways that he was very, very abusive and manipulative in the things that he said and the things that he did. But she was still willing to stay because he had that golden tongue, so to speak, where he could speak anything and she would buy it and she would believe it, even to the point where when she was finding evidence that he was a murderer, she justified it away and made excuses for it to convince herself that it wasn't really him. And so I think in that sense, Zac Efron was a good choice because he is somebody that you only really ever see as like a pretty face. But this, to me, was the performance of a lifetime. I don't think that he's ever had a movie where he's acted more fully into his character, but also more convincingly, because there were points in the movie where when he was saying that he didn't do these crimes, you almost wanted to believe him just because he did that good of a job of portraying himself as like a clean-cut individual. And I think that one of the greatest things that made him so creepy in this movie is the fact that he was not creepy at all. And that makes a huge difference when you're talking about a real-life individual like Ted Bundy who was able to live and be amongst the general population and nobody ever noticed anything. It's just the simple fact that he could be so intensely cruel but nice to everybody around him, and they didn't even see it coming. So I think that was a really good choice of casting. All right, now with Lily Collins, she played Elizabeth, Ted Bundy's long-term love interest and former fiance, and somebody in real life who he had manipulated for, I believe it was almost 7 years total. I think that if you look back at historical pictures of Liz, and then you look at Lily Collins, I think they looked similar. They feel like they had similar demeanors. And I feel like in the movie that Lily was somebody that the way that she portrayed Liz was you felt for her because you felt like she was being manipulated. Not in a sense of, oh my gosh, she's in danger, I have to get her out of there, because you never actually felt like Ted was going to hurt her or that she was in imminent danger, but just the fact that you knew, obviously, in the long run, it was going to come back to bite her. And I feel like the twist at the end, where it turned out that she was the one that called the cops on him, that made it kind of all the more of a little bit shocking, just for the simple fact she was so meek, she was so soft-spoken, she was so calm, that when it turned out that she was the one that kind of pulled the trigger on the whole thing going under investigation, it kind of surprised you, because if you don't know the Ted Bundy story, you don't know what all actually transpired, you wouldn't believe that somebody that obviously that was manipulated and abused and treated wrongly throughout the years, but had a mindset that he was still a good guy, you wouldn't have really necessarily thought that that was somebody that could speak up and to stand up against him in the long run. So I feel like in that sense, she played the character to a T. I think she did a good job with making herself out to be that vulnerable person. And they did a good job of explaining things from her point of view, where throughout the whole movie up until the end, you never actually saw that violent side of Ted Bundy. And because that's how she was, that's what she saw, that's what she experienced in our eyes, was the fact that she was an innocent bystander, both in person, like in reality, and in the movie, and I feel like they conveyed that really well. I'm not going to get really into a whole lot of details when it comes to the other characters. I will say that I feel like they cast them very well. I think Jim Parsons as the lead attorney, I feel like that was a good casting, because again, that was a little bit of a anti-type casting. Obviously, we're used to seeing him in comedy roles and things like that. I believe he did a serious role in HBO. You'd have to quote me on the network, I'm not sure. But obviously, it's something that you don't necessarily see Jim Parsons as. And so it was, again, kind of like a little breathtaking, like, oh, like, okay. But then you immediately bought into it because of the way that he portrayed it. And I think that he did an excellent job being that driven and serious attorney, that he wanted justice and he wasn't buying into what Ted was selling. I think Haley Joel Osment, I think that for not being seen for so long, it was kind of cool to see him. And that's just kind of cool for me, because I grew up in that era where, you know, he was a big star and everybody thought he was going to be a big thing. So obviously with stuff like that, you love to see people in that sense kind of get back up on the horse, so to speak. But I think that he played his character well. He came across genuinely at first as the concerned boss, and then you saw him kind of start moving that into the romantic sense. And I feel like he was kind of that good buffer where we as viewers saw him as, we didn't see him in a bad way because he was intruding. We saw him as somebody that was there to comfort and provide. And you even saw in a couple of the scenes where he was there to protect Liz. And I think that that made him a really strong character. Even though he didn't have that huge of a part, I think it made a difference. Somebody so likable like Haley Joel Osment played it, I think that was a big, big decision, and it was really good casting, in my opinion. One small thing that a lot of people didn't seem to catch is James Hetfield from Metallica. He played the deputy that initially pulled Ted Bundy over and got him with all the stuff in his car. It was kind of a cool little casting to me. I don't know, maybe somebody else doesn't feel that way, but I thought it was kind of cool, just for the fact that it's James Hetfield. So cool to me. Anyways, casting aside, I feel like the pacing of the movie, I think in that regard, it probably could have went a little bit better, because if you came into the movie expecting a typical Ted Bundy movie, and in saying that, I mean typical documentaries and movies and things like that on the subject, they were very focused on him, his actions, his like evil and just cruel intentions. And I think that a lot of people came into this movie expecting that. And so they were expecting more of a a grisly, maybe even gory, like faster paced movie. And I think that's why a lot of people kind of got turned off to this, was the fact that it was very slow paced. It was more storytelling. It was very character driven, and it made you want to care and emotionally invest into the people in the film because you were seeing the human side of them. And that even includes the human side of Ted Bundy. Because a lot of times you see him in old stories, you see pictures, and you automatically, like, you think of him as just some cold, callous killer, but you never actually think about the fact that outside of his crimes, he was a very well-spoken, very likable, very kind, very, very human person. And this film, I think, really showed that in a sense that it put that human compassion, that human aspect, and that kind of gentleness to him that you don't usually see. So I think it was important that they paced it the way that they did. I think that there was times where it did drag a little bit, but without a shadow of a doubt, I would say that the greatest 15 minutes of the film were the last 15 minutes where there was the final confrontation in the telephone room where they were talking, and he just lettered out hacksaw at the bottom, and then it flashed back to him actually attacking the woman, and I think that that was where it all just kind of came together, because we had spent the previous time in the movie getting drawn into that emotional side and getting to know them as characters and things like that. And so to finally see that conclusion where he came out and he said, yeah, that was me. But to do it so coldly and to look at Liz and just without even blinking, be like, yeah, I did that. I think that that was a great kind of crescendo to the film up to that point, where without going overboard, notice you didn't see a whole lot of gore, you didn't see a whole lot of guts or anything like that that you would typically expect to see out of a serial killer movie. I think the emotional buildup more than made up for any gore, guts, or blood or anything like that that they could have put, and I feel like that made this movie even more important. So to return to my point of what I was saying at the very beginning, whenever I said I think a lot of the reviewers got this wrong, it's because they came into it looking for a typical hack and slash serial killer movie. They came into it looking for a typical Ted Bundy film where it was all about Ted and his actions and the things that he did terribly and stuff like that. And that's not what this movie was about. This movie was about portraying him as a vulnerable human and as somebody who was, you know, outwardly fighting for his life. And as a female in, or I'm sorry, as a female companion in Liz, that as she fought for his freedom because she didn't buy into it and she wanted to protect him, there was very much more of a human aspect of this movie than anything that we've seen in any other Ted Bundy movies or stories or anything like that in the past. And I feel like that was important to tell the story because it cemented that fact you don't really truly ever know anybody. And yeah, anybody can be portrayed as a serial killer. But to me, the more terrifying thing is that any serial killer is also a person. And it's important for us to see that human side and to experience them as a person, because I feel like that kind of makes us more aware of the fact that we don't know somebody and what they're capable of. And so there's always the possibility something like this could happen. And in a sense of Ted Bundy, it happened a lot because he was so well-spoken. He was so charismatic. And in a lot of ways, he was a good-looking guy. And I think that that, above all, is what's trying to be portrayed in this movie, is that it's not just about hacking and slashing and guts and gore. There's a very raw human aspect and raw emotion that we get invested in with human beings where we refuse to see the bad in them, where we want to put ourselves out there to try to protect people. And you see so many people stay in abusive relationships because they justify away bad behaviors and they fail to see what's really wrong with somebody because of love and care and that charisma that people have in order to be able to talk themselves out of situations. And I feel like that's a very important thing that a lot of people missed with this. And to me, I would give the movie 8 out of 10. I would definitely watch it again. I guarantee you I end up watching it again. And I would suggest it to friends, because it teaches you that investment that you have to have, but also what to watch out for when you do invest in people. So overall, excellent movie. Like I said, 8 out of 10. First time I've ever done a review like this. Drop some comments down below. Let me know what you think. If you like these reviews, I'd be more than glad to do them again. But until then, this is The Amazing Bacon, and I will talk to you guys later.